Once upon a time, lived a boy named Scott. Born with an upside-down smile, a young Scott lacked purpose. Then, he discovered professional wrestling, and Scott became happy. Along the way, he made a friend in Dan Evans. Together, they caused mayhem, with Scott even managing to vanquish the vile, disgusting, nasty goth. However, one day, Scott, after completely destroying Sean Early in a completely one-sided performance, found himself at a crossroads. Because after beating Sean, Scott was rightfully awarded the number one contendership.
Yes, he was. His fellow mercenary, Dan Evans, had also won the Wrestling Island Championship. Torn, Scott had a very difficult decision to make. What would he do? Dan Evans, I will not be challenging for the Wrestle Island Championship. You really, 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 really wanted us to implode, didn't you? You wanted the fireworks. You see, here's the situation. You flick through your channels, and Phil Mitchell is cheating on his latest girlfriend in EastEnders. You carry on flicking through your channels, and your favorite celebrity is cheating on the latest spouse. Even you. Even you can't maintain your own relationships. I would stab my own grandmother in the back, but if there's one person in this world I wouldn't stab in the back, it's Dan Evans. The issue we've got here is though, I still want to be considered the number one contender, and I don't think it's fair that you take that away from me. So, the way I see things, until someone manages to dethrone the rightful number one contender for the Wrestle Island Championship, I guess that we just don't get another Wrestle Island Championship match. You can call me Shield for Dan Evans' Wrestle Island Championship reign. Maybe. Rules.